Hello everyone. In this session, we'll discuss on software process. So by the term process, so we know that it's a method of performing a task, method of doing something. So the software process, so it's a method of doing the software development. So that is called as a software process. So it specifies a method of developing the software. But if you consider a software organization, software development company, so there will be several activities, several processes, like the business process, the training process, or say for example, the social process. Like this, there will be plenty or various types of activities or processes. But we consider here only the development process. That is, the technical and the management issues of software development is considered as a software process. So, the process that deals with the technical and management issues of software development is called a software process. So it specifies activities at an abstract level that are not project specific. So, the process what we discuss or what software engineering suggests, it is not a project specific or a particular problem specific. It is a general idea. So, general methodology. So, it is just a generic set of activities. Totally here also, the objective of software engineering is the quality and productivity, as we discussed many times. So, the goal of software engineering is to meet the main objective, that is reduce the cost and increase the quality and also the productivity consistently. So the software process, by software process, it suggests some of the methodologies, a systematic approach for the software development. So that the software process is mainly divided into two components. One is called the product engineering process. Another is a process management process. So, one deals with the product engineering process and another mainly deals with the process management process. So, once again, the product engineering process, if you consider, it is categorized or it is divided into development process, project management process and software configuration management process. So, the product engineering process is divided into again three types or three components: development process, project management process and software configuration management. And another software process is a process management process. So, we'll see, we have seen the three main components under product engineering process. So, here the development process. The development process specifies development and quality assurance activities. So, we have different phases to follow. So, once the problem is undertaken for computerization or for automation, so there are defined phases to follow. So, maybe say for example, the requirement specification or analysis of requirement specification, then designing of the solution, so then coding, then finally testing. So all these we know that these are all the different phases of software development. So the development process mainly deals with all these phases, mainly about the software development process, and at the same time the quality assurance activities. So, how to reach the quality, how to reach those factors already we discussed about the functionality, reliability, efficiency, all those factors which decides the quality of the software. So, that is mainly concentrated in the development part or the development process. So, another part of this category is the project management process. So, along with the development, so another important thing is, so the software should be under control always. So, the setting of the cost, then providing the resources or total planning. So, the schedule setting, the cost setting or the, for example, the quality measures that needs to be taken. So that will be undertaken by the team called as a project management process. So it mainly specifies how to plan and control activities so that the cost, schedule, quality and other objectives are met. Already we have discussed the cost, schedule and quality are the three important factors. We should be always in control, otherwise the projects may enter into the runaway projects. Runaway projects means which is not under the control of the cost, schedule and quality. So then it is of no use. So therefore, the project management process, the team, they continuously monitor, they plan first. So the cost of the project, the schedule of the project, the resources needed. So all these things will be planned by the project management process and they continuously monitor. So whether all these factors are under control and all the, say for example, the quality factors are met or not, whether it is, whether we can get a quality product finally, so that will be monitored or checked continuously by the project management process. So then one more category is a software configuration management process. So this team or this part of software process mainly deals with the changes. As we have seen earlier that the maintenance is the change is the main challenging factor for software development. So once the software is developed, so you need to change it because of several reasons. Maybe because of the errors encountered during the use of the software, or the client may change or extend some of the features in the software. Maybe because of several reasons. So we need to change the software. Mainly the changes, it will be under the control of the software configuration management process. It deals with managing the change so that integrity of the product is not violated despite changes. So when we do the changes, we should be very careful that it should how it affects the other modules, other part of the programs. So that there is a separate processing part called as a software configuration management process to deal with the changes required in the software. So then one more component of the software process, that is the process management process. So the software engineering suggests or it gives some guidelines for the development of the software in account of achieving the quality and the productivity. So that it suggests some of the methodologies or some of the process or different phases in the software development. But the software development process is not a static entity. It is not constant. Like once the methodology is defined, so every programmer or every team or every software development team has to follow only those methodologies. It cannot be so. Because the software process is a dynamic entity. So we need to change that methodologies. We need to adopt new techniques, technologies. So in the field of development, so that is mainly considered in process management process, mainly because software process is a dynamic entity. It keeps on changing. So must change to adapt to our increased understanding about software development and availability of newer technologies and tools, all those things. So continuous research studies will be done on in the field of how it can be developed, what changes needs to be done in the field of software development or the methodologies, what modification needs to be done. So continuously a research or study will be done in this field and that will be implemented. So that is done by the process management process. So this part of the process mainly concentrate on adoption of the new technology, adoption of the new tools available or modification needed to the methodologies, all those things. So the objective is to improve the software process. The main objective of process management process is to improve the software process. So it involves understanding the current process, analyzing its properties, the drawbacks in the current process or current methodologies, how it works. So the advantages or disadvantages of that, the survey will be made, study will be made on the available processes. So analyzing its properties, and also if any improvements needed or any modification that can be implemented, that will be done by the process management process. And it is performed by the group of a team called as a SEPG. So it stands for Software Engineering Process Group. So this group mainly concentrate on the research and study in the field of improvements in the field of process, software process or software development. So mainly, so these are all the main activities in the software development. We are concentrating only the technological and management issues, not about the other activities. So there will be several activities in the software development company, but mainly the software engineering takes only the development process and the management issues, or mainly reaching the objective of quality and the productivity. So with this, we'll conclude today's session. Thank you.